Hello guys, welcome back to our channel, Mental Health Sanctuary. Psilocybin mushrooms, sometimes known as magic mushrooms or shrooms, have been used as a spiritual and medical tool by Indigenous peoples for thousands of years. In today's video, we will examine psilocybin treatment in detail, including the advantages and disadvantages and how to decide if it's good for you. What exactly is psilocybin therapy? Psilocybin therapy, also known as psilocybin-assisted therapy, includes the use of a hallucinogenic substance native to a specific type of mushroom in a psychotherapeutic setting. What does a psilocybin therapy session look like? Psilocybin therapy involves a patient consuming psilocybin while under the supervision of a therapist. In this supervised, safe atmosphere, the patient enters a psychedelic trip, which the therapist facilitates. The session lasts 6 to 8 hours, which is the length of time the drug's effects last. In some cases, patients may take the medication more than once. The general standard is that the psychedelic journey coincides with standard talk therapy, often continuing after. Who can benefit from psilocybin therapy? Psilocybin treatment is frequently used for people who are resistant to traditional therapies. Patients with chronic illness. A single dose of psilocybin has been shown to improve depression and anxiety in people with life-threatening cancer. Furthermore, the improvements were long-lasting, with 60% to 80% of the group continuing to experience relief from those symptoms over the next 6 months. Another trial of cancer patients found that more than 80% felt better 6 months after taking the single dose medication. In addition, they reported changes in their attitudes toward life, emotions, and spirituality, as well as decreased depression, anxiety, and feelings of dread or hopelessness regarding their condition. People suffering from depression and anxiety. Depression and anxiety may be major, incapacitating disorders that discourage people from carrying out their routine activities. The results of studies have been no less profound for patients whose depression had previously been resistant to treatment. According to one study, 13 of 20 individuals improved and 4 experienced depressive remission. Likewise, a meta-analysis of 24 trials found that 65% of individuals with anxiety reported decreased anxiety following psilocybin therapy treatment. It is evident that psilocybin treatment has the potential to reduce depression and anxiety symptoms. PTSD patients. Post-traumatic stress disorder symptoms can last for years after a terrible experience and impact many aspects of life. Psilocybin has been examined and shown to be effective in treating people with PTSD. Other psychedelics, such as MDMA and ketamine, have been explored in the treatment of PTSD. Other uses. Several studies on the use of psilocybin treatment for drug addiction, smoking cessation, Alzheimer's disease, and other conditions have been published. Specifically, studies like The Therapeutic Potential of Psilocybin by N. Toyang state that psilocybin is reported to result in significant changes in brain dynamics and functional connectivity, FC, between areas of the brain. This may help explain why its use has had such substantial outcomes and why it has lasted longer than other types of therapy. Based on various studies, the benefits of psilocybin therapy include the following. Depression rates have decreased. Chronic depression is moving into remission. Reduced anxiety. Improved mood. Less dread about the future. Enhanced spirituality and connectedness, and a higher quality of life. No therapy is a cure-all. Some people will always react differently to specific treatments than others. However, according to current research, nearly two-thirds of people who try psilocybin treatment report lasting positive effects. This includes populations with disorders that have previously resisted treatment. Unfortunately, because studies have only been supported for the last 2 decades and have only been supported by the US government for the last 2 to 3 years, much more study is still needed. Things to reflect upon. Because psilocybin is a psychoactive medication, it is essential to be adequately informed before considering its use. Therefore, it should always be done in the presence of a licensed therapist who is trained in its therapeutic use. Potential for addiction. Even though psilocybin is not typically considered an addictive drug, those with a history of substance misuse may be tempted to use it again outside their treatment context. This is a complex subject because medicine has been studied to treat some substance use disorders, so talk to your practitioner about it thoroughly. It might bring up uncomfortable emotions. Even if the therapy has beneficial impacts, it may not be an entirely pleasurable experience. That is why it is essential that it be conducted by someone who can assist you if things go wrong. It's necessary to realize that to go through traumatic elements of your life, and you'll most likely have to address them head-on in the session. Even when not under the influence of psychedelics, this can be terrifying. Patients with heart conditions should take caution. There has been some speculation that psilocybin may induce cardiac difficulties. However, there is no conclusive data to support this. Consult your doctor if you have any cardiac or medical challenges. Psilocybin treatment is very new and is actively being researched. If this is something you're interested in, be aware about its legal status where you live, so that as it becomes more available, you have the choice to test it. But in the meanwhile, don't hold back starting therapy. It can help you at any moment, and while its effects aren't as powerful as psychedelics, it's still incredibly beneficial. With this, we come to the end of the video. If you enjoyed the content, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you at the next one. Stay tuned and take care. Till then, goodbye.